On today's episode, we're going to take you exploring inside Elements Pottery, nestled alongside the world famous Four Roses Distillery. Hey y'all, my name is Angel Yamrod and I'm going to be your host. Come along with me and my co-host, Jeff Waldridge, as we take you exploring around Anderson County and Lawrenceburg, Kentucky. So join us as we take you beyond the barrel.
All right, so this should be fun, right?
Yeah, I'm actually kind of ashamed that I really didn't know more about this place. So yeah. I'm really excited for us to get a journey.
Maybe we go in here and, you know, react the scene from Ghost. It'd be awesome.
We could do that, only if Patrick Swayze was really here. This is Susan Burge, and she's with Elements Pottery. She is the owner here. And so she is going to be actually giving us the tour and letting us experience some of the things she does on a daily basis.
Sounds like a great idea. Oh. All right, so Susan, if you wanted to show us around, you know, show us what you have to offer.
Okay, so this is my gift shop area. And in here I have a lot of my handmade pots. And then I also have a lot of items from other artisans and local and not local. Okay.
And you even got the bourbon fudge,
I see. I've got the bourbon caramels, and I've got bourbon fudge. I try to do a lot of bourbon themed items since I'm right next door to Four Roses Distillery. So that works out really well. Just small little gift shop.
Smells great in here. What's the
That's the candle behind you, I think, or this soap that's right here. The soap, people comment on how good it smells.
This one does. So I said sugar plum. Just let you check out
this one. It's got loofah built into it, and
is that what the
That's what that is. It's a loofah sponge.
Oh, I'm gonna put it up here.
That's really cool.
See how
that cool?
That is really awesome.
It's called a flip-flop soap. So one side has shea butter and one side has
So it's moisturizing loofah. And the loofah. So, that is so neat.
Cool?
That is really neat. Never have I ever seen that.
So I've got bourbon soap. This is out of Winchester, Kentucky. So
you stay local with some things. Yeah. Oh, you can drink it?
No.
Oh,
drink bourbon.
I was like, how'd that happen? Okay.
Angel, why would you drink water if you bathe in it? What do you
have? Yeah, you know.
You can drink bourbon.
Yes.
You can bathe in bourbon.
Okay. Don't drink
you can
the water.
Eat bourbon.
Well, I was actually thinking maybe there was like a special way the soap went. You melted it down. I was like,
you may drink it.
Okay. Yeah.
Whatever
you're in. Whatever. Okay, so there's all that. Handmade pots.
So what do you got planned for Angel today?
So Angel,
we want to put her through the ringer.
Run you through the ropes today. We're going to do a little bit of everything. And I thought we'd start in here in the Paint Your Own Pottery studio.
Okay.
And the studio is where people can come anytime, walk in, pick a piece, and put their own designs on it.
Okay,
and
awesome.
I'm here to help them any way I can. And you do not have to know how to draw.
Okay, I was gonna say, disclaimer, I am not an artist. Yes. I am terrible at this, so yes. I'll
so this is the thing I like to do with a lot of kids, because it's a blast, and you don't have to know how to paint anything. We're gonna take this cup right here with blue glaze in it, stir it up, okay, and we're gonna blow into it with our straw.
Oh, really?
And bubbles are gonna come out of it, and we're gonna blow those bubbles and let them land on the plate, all right? Here is all we need. And you can see the glaze is already gathering to where the edges of the bubbles are. And we just kind of let that sit and dry.
Okay.
So just kind of lightly blow it. That way we don't have to.
How your experience?
look at Susan's compared to Angel's.
Artwork.
All right. The master versus the apprentice.
Hey, it's still going to look really good. Do you have no faith in me, Jeff?
No.
So all ages, that means, is really welcome.
Yeah. So I did a spring break class, and we made that turtle chip and dip thing.
I love one.
And so we did the background with bubbles, and we used like three different colors on that one, I think. And then they put the turtle in there and painted the
little bowl like the turtle shell.
Okay, so next we've got our plates dry, and now we're gonna blow a second color on there. And I chose a red and blue because 4th of July is right around the corner.
Yes.
We need to have a 4th of July plate.
Yeah, okay. So this is a good opportunity. I mean, I noticed there's tons of pottery around here, so really come in and do it for a holiday and make a gift for somebody.
Father's Day's coming up. I've had a lot of people come in and do handprint items for Father's Day, and so you can do a lot of cool things. Just for your home or for a special occasion, so that's really nice.
And you mentioned it's for all ages.
It's
really
for all ages, yeah.
I mean, if you can't blow bubbles.
Yeah, anybody can blow bubbles, right? So let's do our second layer.
Okay.
I've had several people from touring the distillery that stopped in to paint pottery, and then I just ship it to them wherever they are, and so that's never an issue. If somebody wants to come in and paint, or traveling, and they don't want to take it home with them, or you know, it's something you have to wait a week for. So then I'm happy to ship it to them.
Yeah. So once you do this, then it's like you wait a week and you come back and you pick up the items.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So yep.
This is awesome.
Okay, so that's it. So what we would do is just let this dry, and then I dip it into clear glaze, and I fire it in the kiln, and then you come pick it up when it's ready.
Oh, awesome. Okay. Well, I'm going to let Jeff get a close-up of mine. I'm really liking the... My center is going to look really good.
Yep. Got me good.
I feel bad holding up next to Susan's, though.
Notice the comparison.
Notice the comparison.
Susan.
I practice doing bubbles on a daily basis. What's Susan doing today? She's over there blowing bubbles.
What does she do over there?
How do you feel about the artistic abilities?
On a scale of 1 to 10, my artistic abilities are a 1, but let me tell you that it's really easy, and so I'm feeling like when I get all my artwork, it's going to be like a 10. So, hey, that's a good thing.
Well, at least you didn't lose a finger. You didn't lose an eye. Okay.
Okay. We're not through yet. So,
you know,
I mean,
it's very early.
So. Yeah.
So Susan's setting up the picture. Is that what we're planning to
This is a picture we're going to start painting.
Okay.
And I do classes on a regular basis. So, you need paint. Just me.
She doesn't want me to paint. She has a bad feeling about this.
Scared.
So, I am going to go ahead and put my apron on here.
Put your awesome apron.
Yes. I love it. It has kind of like a tie-dye effect to it. So, and actually it matches the shirt really well. Now Susan was telling me also, I know right now a big thing all over the U.S. is the painting in class with your friends and stuff. So you do that in here also. So
yes.
Yeah, that's I know a lot of my friends are huge with that. So that's a good thing.
It's even if, you know, even if you're just doing it to get with your friends and have a good time and just experience it.
Yeah.
Don't worry too much about coming out with a perfect painting. Most of the paintings look really great, you know, so it's more about just getting out with your friends and having a good time.
Yeah, and laughing. So that's a good night out for the girls, or even like a bridal shower would be really
Absolutely.
Cool. So,
We're gonna draw our horizon line straight across. What? She can draw a straight line, that's awesome. Okay, so we're gonna take this piece.
When they taught you to stay in the line.
And that's hurt your life the entire way.
You've been behind ever since.
Yeah. See, kids, you miss one day and what happens?
Did you know there's something outside of a full moon? They haven't named it yet.
Yeah, well, that's what it is right there. You're seeing it.
The angel moon.
Okay, yeah. All right.
Okay, that is awesome.
Okay, Angel. We're in my wheel throwing studio, and this is where the magic happens.
It's looking magical right now.
You know. So, it's kind of a crazy room. Mm-hmm. I do a lot of things. You know, the clay lives and breathes in here, and I recycle clay. So over there is kind of my recycling area and my wedging area. Okay. And then, I've got four wheels. And so what I can do is I can give classes with up to four people.
That's awesome.
People can kind of schedule a class just for their group as a private party, mm-hmm. or they can jump in on classes that I offer.
Offer. Okay, so you do have set classes that you automatically yes. offer, and then yeah. you can schedule outside of your normal hours if they need to. Yep.
So I give classes anywhere from, I let people, they can call, you know, a day ahead of time and say, hey, I want to come in for a little 20-minute session. Mm-hmm. And that's just a way to get their hands on clay and give it a try.
Yeah.
And then I give 1-hour classes, 2-hour classes, and I also do a 5-week class. And that's for people who want to learn how to do it all.
Oh, okay. And be more advanced. And
yeah.
I mean, there's a lot of great pieces you've made in your gift shop. So
yeah. So
to be able to do that and actually take them home and use them.
Yeah, it's really fun, and we all kind of have a great time. The last class we eat pizza and glaze all of our pieces, and everybody seems to really
enjoy it. Yeah, yeah. So. Well, that was even with the painting. It was neat to, you know, I'm sure you get a lot of laughs and everything out of each thing.
Okay, so we got to start out putting this apron on.
And so that's the required uniform.
This is the required uniform, and I need to give the class in just putting this apron on, I think.
I want to show you all the...
This is going to be great.
So yeah, I cleaned them up. Now this is probably like 2 months worth of, more than 2 months. I'm going to say 6 months worth of clay on here.
She's experienced, but she's here to help. Okay.
All right, so we are gonna throw a bowl on the pottery wheel.
So this is where the magic happens.
This is where the magic happens.
I'm kind of speechless, really. It's awesome.
Okay. She's intimidated. You can see the intimidation on her face. There will be clay everywhere.
It'll be bad.
Okay, so now I'm going to shape it. And okay. The way I shape it is I change where my pressure comes from. So
okay.
Inside hand is going to push the clay outward, okay? While my outside hand is supporting that clay. Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm just going to pull this way. Okay, so then I'm done throwing that bowl. I'm gonna take a sponge, get it wet, squeeze out most of the water, clean up that inside, do a little compression, and then I have this wood tool. I'm gonna get it wet, and I'm gonna use it to just kind of scoop up some of this extra clay down here that I don't really need, okay? So I just did that. All right, and then I'm gonna shut my wheel off. I think I am, there we go. I'm gonna take this wire tool, put it down on here, and just cut that bowl. It releases the bowl from the wheel head, okay? And so then I am done. I have thrown the bowl.
Absolutely amazing.
Okay, so now the process is this will sit and get leather hard, which is kind of like cheddar cheese stage.
Mm-hmm.
I can pick it up then, I can handle it kind of like these mugs right here.
What do you think, Jeff?
I think this is gonna be awesome. We're gonna put some nice sensual music in this. We're gonna cue that little ghost.
Patrick Swayze.
Oh yeah, we're gonna channel Patrick Swayze.
Patrick Swayze. Okay.
long, lonely time. And time goes by so slowly, and time can do so much. All you still more.
Okay. I hope I missed that part, didn't I?
There you go. Now we're gonna have a little problem, so I'm gonna go in and fix that problem.
Yes.
Okay.
This is referred to as phone a friend.
911, a claim.
We're actually, I think I'm doing better than I expected.
You're actually doing way better.
Actually. Oh, sorry. Watching her.
Look at the hands.
Yes. You can't be afraid to get muddy. Definitely. Or pottery.
Pottery? Muddy?
Clay.
Muddy is right. Get dirty doing this.
I think that's all the right. Fun part, though.
That is lovely.
This is truly an experience,
yeah,
too.
Release it right there. Okay. All right. That's it. Go ahead and release it. Slow your wheel way down.
I think I'm on automatic, maybe? Oh, okay. I was stuck.
All right.
Turn it back on?
No.
Oh.
I'm afraid it's going to collapse. So.
Oh. We wanted to collapse.
No, we do not.
Trimmed. And then something like this. I put a little handle on it and fire it up.
Awesome. I think that's going to make an awesome gravy bowl. This is the prize, Jeff.
It's a gravy bowl.
This is. It's going to be. Wait
it's
until.
A lot of gravy.
Wait until my Thanksgiving dinner, family. This is it.
You hear that, family?
Watch
you're going to get that bow on your table at Thanksgiving.
Yes. And I'll just lay it over here with yours.
Lay it over there.
Disclaimer, you do get dirty, but it's not too dirty. You can still dress in whatever you want. And
there's proof.
Yep. And it's not like we got it all over us, but I would probably dress down a little more casual.
Yeah, I usually tell people not to wear their nice rings because
yes.
It does get caked into diamonds.
Yes.
It'll come out. I mean, you just soak them, but you know, you try to avoid
and,
it.
Yes.
And that's exactly what Angel did remove.
I'm not worried about it.
It'll be okay.
Yeah.
And you know, if you have white clothes on, mm-hmm. You can stain them. So,
you ever have anybody the wheel just gets out of control and like goes everywhere?
Yeah, I've had balls of clay fly off the wheel, and I keep telling them to aim it towards my window because I could use it.
Right.
That's a good idea. See, Jeff, so I did better than some.
There you go.
I did better. Mm-hmm. I'm happy.
All right, I think you can practice.
So you probably have people who keep coming back and doing lots of things.
Yeah, so I just try to build that interest, and there's people who just latch onto it and really enjoy it.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's a great experience. I mean, definitely, if you haven't experienced Elements Pottery, you should definitely make a trip over. If you're local or staying out of town, we have great places to stay, so you can just stay in one of the local hotels and come on over and do Elements. It's a great fun. So that's a wrap here at Elements Pottery Studio. Susan is very welcoming. She welcomes all locals, out-of-towners, or anyone just wanting to swing by and check things out. Mention Beyond the Barrel to get 10% off pottery painting, and we can't wait to show you all more of Lawrenceburg.